But yes, Alzheimer's disease is one of the neurodegenerative diseases that are up in the top four or five, like you mentioned, causes
death. Well, it's
death.
The top. It's the only neurodegenerative disease that's on the top 10 list of death.
Top 10, yeah. Yep. So cardiovascular disease.
So cardiovascular is far and away number one. It's not even, I mean, cancer as in an aggregate is number two, but as an oncologist, I sort of take an issue with that because cancer is a completely heterogeneic form of diseases. So, to put this in perspective, right? So breast cancer, who's not afraid of breast cancer if you're a woman? Breast cancer accounts for 3% of deaths in women. I was shocked to learn that. Very low. I would have thought much, much higher. Now, cancer in women, all cancers, 20, 21%. Mm-hmm. Cardiac disease, 22, 23%. So if you're a woman, if you ask anyone on the street, are you more afraid of heart disease or breast cancer? I think most women would understandably say breast cancer. Yeah. And yet it dwarfs. It's dwarfed by cardiac disease by a factor of 7.5 to 1.
And we definitely know that diet and lifestyle play a major role in your, risk for cardiovascular disease.
Yeah. I mean, I think there's no place where that's more obvious than actually in Alzheimer's disease for other reasons, which is...
Oh, really? Alzheimer's?
Yeah, I think so,
More than cardiovascular?
Well, I mean, I say that just based on what I call the existence principle, right? So cardiac disease, I mean, I think that's entirely true. I think cardiac disease is inevitable, right? Mm-hmm. And while we've had a deterioration in our lifestyle over the past 40 years, pretty precipitated and accelerated sort of move in the wrong direction on that, it's been largely offset by pretty amazing medical advances. So there's the three things that have, I think, allowed cardiac disease to remain. In fact, it's actually come down. If you look at the death rate from cardiac disease, it's come down. So it's still the number one killer, but it's actually on a downward slope. I mean, it's sort of plateauing. But when you look at what sort of the three biggest drivers are of cardiac disease, the first one is not disputed. It's smoking. So the data are really clear that if you could only make one behavioral change to reduce your risk of heart disease, it's don't smoke.
Yeah.
The next two are actually, because they are so cross-correlated, you can't actually distinguish which one's more important, are hypertension and elevated APOB, or LDL particle number. Mm-hmm. And again, APOB is the single best biomarker, or LDLP, to distinguish your risk of cardiac disease. It trumps LDL cholesterol, it trumps non-HDL cholesterol, it trumps triglycerides, HDL cholesterol. Those things don't hold a candle to LDL particle number, APOB. Well, think about it. Think about the advances we've made in the last 40 years on all of those, right? So smoking has gone from, 45% of the population to 18% of the population. So we reduce smoking.
In the U.S.
In the U.S., that's right. Obviously, we haven't done the same across the in the developing world. Think of the litany of drugs we have for controlling hypertension. And think about the litany of drugs we have to bring down ApoB. So despite enormous improvements in the three big picture drivers, it's still the number one killer. So it's got to be lifestyle driven, but we're blunting the effect of that. Whereas in Alzheimer's disease, we don't really have any pharmacotherapy plays. Like, we're still arguing about what the environmental trigger is. Mm-hmm. Is it all diet driven? Is it sleep driven? Is it stress driven? What's the combination of factors? Yeah. Is it a virus? Or is it prions? I mean, I've heard every argument under the sun, right? But here's what we do know. We know that in the last 50 years, the prevalence of Alzheimer's disease has gone up about 2.5%. Whereas the increase in our per year, by the way, I'm sorry,
per
that's
year.
Per
okay.
year. Whereas we know that our longevity has increased at about 0.6% per year over that same period of time. Now, over a 50-year period, a 2% spread per year of prevalence, actually, I think it might be incidence now that I think about it. I think it's incidence and longevity suggests that Alzheimer's disease isn't just the natural response of getting old. Mm-hmm. There's something driving it. And even if you accept that part of that increase in incidence is a greater appreciation for the diagnosis, it's hard to argue that makes up the full 2% spread.
Yeah.
And so that's why I think that, to me, that's the most convincing case for why there is something in our environment that's triggering Alzheimer's disease, and it is not just the natural consequence of aging.